Hey folks, it's Cynthia Deeren here. Here's a question I received recently that I thought I'd answer for you on video. And the question is, hey Cynthia, I'm thinking of selling my product overseas. What level of due diligence do I need to do to make sure that the product is suitable for the local market? Now, this is a great question because there's an almost endless amount of market research that you could do before you start tackling a new market. And for some people, the sheer volume of potential research stops them from ever getting started. The trick here is to work out what you need to know before you go ahead and launch. So today, I want to highlight four questions that you should ask when you're trying to work out whether what you sell is likely to do well in a particular country. Now, these aren't necessarily the only four things that matter, but if you can get a yes on all four of these factors, then I'd say it's likely that you've got the potential to succeed in your new market. Do enough people need it? That's the first question. So before you lock on a market, you've got to be sure that there are enough people who actually need what you sell. For example, one of my clients is an architectural services firm that does 3D modeling, and they were very keen on expanding their operations to Singapore because it has a great reputation as a Southeast Asian hub. But the more they thought about it, the more they realized that the Singaporean market for what they sold was quite limited because the number of architectural firms that needed their 3D modeling product was pretty small. So they didn't rule Singapore out, but they actually added other regional markets into their strategy as well. The second question is, will they pay for it? So once you've worked out that there are enough people who want to buy your product, it's really important to make sure that people are actually willing to pay for it. You might be targeting a very large market, but one that has a much smaller proportion of people who have the means to buy your product. So there's no point having an awesome corkscrew that you intend to sell for $200 if people in your target market are only willing to pay a maximum of $20 for it. This is a key question that you just can't afford to skip over. The third question is, can I compete? So on that note, you need to be sure that you can actually compete in your sector, in your target market. For instance, if we go back to the corkscrew example, if you plan to sell your awesome corkscrew for $200 and you know that people are willing to pay that much for it in your target market, that's great. But what if there's a competitor with a really strong brand in the corkscrew space that makes a virtually identical product, which it's marketing very, very aggressively for $150. Now, this is the kind of thing that could reduce your market share before you even get started. On its own, the existence of competition isn't a reason to avoid a market, but you do need to be confident that you can compete or that there's a blank space somewhere in that market that you can occupy. Sticking with that corkscrew example, you might be better to target the very top of the market with $1,000 corkscrews, or to go for a low-cost, high-volume play where you sell basic corkscrews for $10. And the fourth question is, can we afford to sell there? Once you've worked out how much consumers in a particular market are likely to pay for a product like yours, you need to go ahead and calculate whether this is compatible with your cost structure. So if you decide that market conditions mean you can only charge $140 for your awesome corkscrew, but it costs you $100 to make and distribute each corkscrew, you might conclude that that likely margin is way too low to make it worth it your while. Now, in a services context, this kind of thing can be a challenge for firms that are supplying to low-cost markets and resourcing their teams with high-cost staff out of high-cost countries. One way around this problem is to establish teams in-country so that you can enable cost-effective pricing that actually chimes with local trends. So, how did you go? I'd love to hear from you about whether you think your product is likely to work in your target market based on the answers to those four questions. I'm Cynthia Deeren, and I'll see you soon.